AP Chemistry scores are out, and I know there's some stress involved when you log in and see how you did. Hi there, my name is Jeremy Krug, and I want to congratulate all of you on completing AP Chemistry and making it through the course and this year's exam. All over the web, I've enjoyed seeing so many of you celebrate your scores today, and I just want to let you know I'm proud of all of you, and it's been an honor to be a part of your educational journey. I do want to share the score breakdown that was released by College Board a couple weeks ago. As you can see, a full 17% of this year's students got fives on the exam. That is absolutely incredible. So that's a big chunk of you that just blew this exam right out of the water. 27% of you got a four, which is also an excellent score. So that's 44% of this year's test takers that really demonstrated a high level of skill on this exam. We had a full 31% of you who got a 3. That's a very respectable score also. It's a little hard to talk about 3s because there's a big chunk of students out there that see that 3 on their score report and they're just absolutely disappointed, crushed, because they were shooting for a 4 or a 5. And then there's another group, also a big chunk of students, that see that 3 and they're absolutely ecstatic because they didn't really think they do that well. So if you got a 3, congratulations. Even if you wanted to score higher, a 3 is a very respectable score and it demonstrates a good knowledge of the AP Chemistry curriculum. Next, we have our 2s. 17% of this year's students got 2s. Now, most students aren't exactly satisfied with a 2, but just remember that a 2 shows that you made a respectable effort on this exam and that you demonstrated a grasp of at least some of the concepts of this course. This year, 8% got a 1. And of course, no one wants to get a 1, but if you took this course and applied yourself and learned chemistry and did your best, then don't be too disappointed if you didn't get the score you wanted. You know, I've been teaching AP Chemistry for a long time. I'm about to start my 25th year teaching this course. And early in my career, I had a student who worked hard, did her best, took the exam, and she got a 2. I don't know what happened. Maybe she had a bad day when she took the exam. Maybe the questions just didn't go her way, but either way, she got a 2. Now, she didn't let that score stop her. She went to college and took General Chemistry 1 and 2, and since she had already had AP Chemistry, it was pretty easy for her. And she kept taking chemistry classes, and now she has a PhD in chemistry. She's completed all this wonderful research that goes way over my head. So don't let yourself be defined by a test score. If you didn't get the score you want, that's okay. You've gained so much knowledge this year. You've learned so many skills, and nobody can take that away from you. And if you didn't get the score you wanted, you can demonstrate your knowledge of chemistry in other ways. You can take the SAT 2 subject exam in chemistry. You can take the CLEP exam, so you can still do this. I know that for a lot of you, AP Chemistry may be the beginning of a long career in the sciences, while for others of you, this may be the last chemistry class you ever take. So either way, thanks for joining me on this journey through chemistry. I hope you've learned a lot, and I'd love to hear in the comments how you did personally. I really love reading your comments and messages. It keeps me going as I make these videos. If you've benefited from my videos this year, I do ask one favor. If you could recommend my videos to those who are following behind you in AP Chem and taking this class next year, I would really appreciate it. I'm spending this summer working on videos and worksheets to make what I hope is going to be the greatest AP Chem prep packet out there, the new AP Chemistry Ultimate Review Packet. I hope you all have a great summer, and thanks again for being a part of this journey.